Good morning. Welcome to the You Are Come Life Tour of Reed Hall. My name is Courtney Soulsby. I'm a student here at the University of Arkansas. I'm about to begin my sophomore year as a nursing major, and I'm super biased towards Reed. I love it because I lived here last year. It's a special place in my heart. Behind the camera is Matea. I'll let her introduce herself.
Hi y'all, my name is Matea Jones. I'm gonna be a senior here at the University of Arkansas. My major is food science. And so, you know, we've got two science majors over here, so if you guys have any questions, let us know. If you have any questions about Reed or the campus, be sure to comment down below. We'll be reading your comments, and so we'll try to get all your questions answered. If not today, during the live video, later on. But yeah, thanks for watching.
So before we go in, I'm just going to point out some of the stuff that's surrounding Reed. Right across the parking lot, as you can see, is the nursing building. And then you have the football stadium. You have a great view of the football stadium from Reed. There's the poultry science building, which holds a lot of classes, so there is a chance that you could have classes in that building. I know that I did my freshman year. And then you have over here the quads, the maples. Right in the bottom corner of this building, right next to you, is a little restaurant called the Melt Lab, and you can use meal trade there at night. It's really convenient. It's open until like 11 p.m. So if you're staying up late studying, it's a great option for dinner. You also have Pub Red in the bottom of this building, which is a little convenience store. They have snacks, chips, drinks, candy, smoothies, and ice cream actually in there. So super convenient. I went there a lot. They have coffee too, really good coffee that I got all the time. The closest dining hall is going to be Fulbright, which is right down that sidewalk. It's a really great dining hall. Get the ice cream there too. Super short walk. It's probably like 5 minutes max.
Lee says hi.
Hello.
And then Nicole, yes, we will be showing an in-room today. We'll get to that when we go inside.
Yes, we're gonna show you all the goods in Reed. So let's head inside. For this tour because I love Reed. It's really fun. I had a great experience here. I miss it already. So this is our fobbing system, which is basically just a security system to make sure that the only people that can get in this building are the people that live in this building. So let's go ahead and I'll take you to the other side of Reed. There's another parking lot over here, so if you do have resident reserve parking, this is an option for you. You find a space over here. Got this nice little...
You have about 15 people to hang out right now?
Oh, awesome.
Yes. Oh, about 25. Hi, guys. 25.
Where are y'all from? We're curious to know.
Yes. Yes, Courtney's local here from Fayetteville. And then I'm from Texas, so if you guys have any Texas people watching, welcome. This is our home away from home here.
Yep, so as you can see, Maple is super close. So if you have any friends that live in Maple, it's a really short walk. And then here's the parking lot, like I said. This is resident reserve. So if you do have resident reserve, you can park here. And I believe they're using this parking lot for move-in. It's a part of move-in. I know that you can find all of the move-in information and parking and stuff online at movein.uark.edu. So if you have any questions about that, you can look there. Yeah.
We have Bailey from Arizona, Gabby from Kansas City, Claire from Katy, Texas, Ashley, I'm right close to you. I'm from Frisco, Texas, so you know,
okay.
We're real close.
Nice, thank you. Yeah, Arizona, wow.
Yeah.
Sometimes we get your mail here in Arkansas.
Yes.
Alaska, Arizona, and Arkansas. We all get each other's mail sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
So this is our front desk area. This is where you would come to pick up packages, which they will email you if you have a package, so you'll know when to come pick it up. And there will always be someone working here that's on the housing staff, so it could be an RA or a CRE. You can always come here, ask them any questions that you have. They're super helpful. In case you lose a key or something, these are the people that you would come to help you. And then over here, will be your mailboxes. So you will also get an email with your mailbox number and your code to get into your mailbox. They're super easy to use. I believe everyone here gets their own mailbox, so that's awesome. And then over here is vending machines. So whenever you're thirsty, want a snack, got some good stuff in here. I believe these take Apple Pay as well.
And Android Pay.
Mm-hmm. And they take cards and cash, so whatever works best for you. I know I use those a lot.
What do you, is there a particular drink that you like? Do you like the iced coffee stuff, or what do you do?
I'm partial to iced coffee.
You are?
Yes.
See, I would always get those Mountain Dew Kickstarts because I stay up late and study.
Those were my emergency drink.
Yeah.
I really needed to stay up late.
Yeah. Which was me all the time. So I drank those a lot.
Right, in case of emergency. Okay.
So here's one little kitchen area. You do have an oven and a stove. I know people made pancakes in here a lot. People came in here to bake cookies. My RAs came down here and cooked stuff for us all the time. So this is open to anyone that wants to use it.
Security violation. Close the door.
We do have a security system, which is awesome. I always felt super safe and read. So this is... Maybe it's for a different door.
Yep, it just might be broken.
It's fine. So this is a study room, or a little hangout room. You can really use it for whatever you wish. It's a nice big couch. I know people, girls, have movie nights in here all the time. People come watch The Bachelor in here.
It's a solid 32, maybe.
Yeah.
HTV, maybe 40.
So you can use this for whatever you wish. It's a good place to hang out. And here's a little table. I know people did use this for studying, so. It's a good room.
Yes.
Here, we'll move on.
Yes, there is going to be an ice maker. It's going to be in the laundry room, which we'll show you here in just a minute.
Here we are. That was one of our maintenance men who fixes things for us all the time. We appreciate it.
So this is a really nice room that we have in Reed. It is our gym area, which anyone that lives here can use. Ellipticals, treadmills, there's weights. It's a really awesome thing to take advantage of if you live here because you don't have to walk to the Hyper or the Union every time you want to work out.
Would you say the Hyper is probably 15 on foot?
Not a bad walk at all, but if it's full or something.
And there is also a workout place in the Union itself.
Yes.
Yeah. And then did we mention the substation?
Oh, so UAPD has a substation in the bottom of Reed. Which is also super cool because that's another reason to feel super safe when you're in here. If you need anything, if you need to ask them anything, this is the door to their office. So.
And they bring their dogs in a lot.
They do. They
like
bring their
for
dogs
fun,
in.
Not for to be petted.
Yeah,
they're real sweet.
You'll come in and see them hanging out in the lobby sometimes. Mm-hmm. They'll let you pet the dog, so look for that.
Questions coming in?
No questions right now. We had a question about the ice maker, which we'll show in the laundry room in just a minute.
Yes.
Gotcha.
We have some more cool spaces to show you guys before we go into the room. So this is one of my favorite hangout spots in here. It's a nice big TV. I watch Fringe in here all the time.
Which episode are you on?
I've rewatched it so many times, and I'm at this point where I just kind of play it in my room when I'm going to sleep. So I wake up, and it's like four episodes ahead of where I really am, so that's a great question. And then here is a bigger kitchen area. There is a fridge that you can use, another oven and stove and microwave, and there's a sink here. So take advantage of this. This is a really nice kitchen area. You can cook in here if you get tired of going to the dining hall, so you just want to have something homemade. You make cookies
cookies are popular. Cookies will make you friends.
Cookies, pancakes, tacos, things like that. They're easy to make. Pizza.
Yes.
Always a pizza happening.
Here's
on
a
campus.
Nice big table, so a lot of your friends could hang out here and
a nice study
together.
Space for you guys.
Definitely.
Here's a nice little outdoor area that you could always use
it's
for
raining.
Studying when it's not cold outside. It's starting to rain out here, but yeah, it's really nice. I always heard people hanging out here. It's a good spot to study or just sit with your friends, especially when it's not cold.
Yes.
Fable gets pretty cold in the winter.
Your RAs will also do lots of great programming down here in these spaces. There's always going to be something to do, to get involved in, so look out for that.
For years past, there's always been a program called Chocolate Wasted that has been out of here, where you get to eat lots of different chocolates. I think it's been elevated to
yes.
a campus-wide event now, but it had its origins here.
I just want to point out that this is the one co-ed restroom in the building, since it is an all-female building.
For the gentlemen?
Yes. This is the one place. That's co-ed. And then this area to my right is where you will bring your trash. You just pop in at that door and you throw your trash out there. So that's where everyone will bring their trash to. And then this is the laundry room. You have a nice TV in here if you want to hang out and wait for your laundry. A bunch of washers, special dryers. We do have, oh, and there's the ice machine,
yes.
For whoever was wondering. We do have a really cool system here called Laundry Alert. There is information about it on the wall back there. But basically, you see these scan here codes? You can scan that, you can download the app. It will tell you when laundry machines are open, so you don't have to come down here and check it constantly. And if you are washing your clothes, you kind of just put in what machine you're using and it will tell you when your laundry is done, so you don't have to sit down here and wait for it, which is really nice when you're living with 604 girls. Is that the number?
459?
I mean, look.
460, I think.
460?
Yeah.
460,
yes.
460.
Bailey wants to know if she has to buy her own laundry soap, and if so, what kind?
You do have to bring laundry detergent. I recommend bringing pods. I know I use Tide pods because they're easy to get down here. But yeah, and the wall does tell you like what they allow, what they don't allow in the laundry rooms. I know you can bring liquid detergent if you choose to, but
liquid or pods is going to be your best bet.
Yes.
To do that.
Yeah, we don't recommend powder at all.
Yes. So yes, Laura, you can use pods.
And I use those at home too, and they're amazing.
Yeah.
It's like they go in there and then they're just gone. Just washed away.
Ice machine for Kimberly. It's really nice. You need some cold ice for your drinks. Yeah. So I think we're gonna, there's some more spaces. Downstairs in this lobby area, you're full of so many spaces to hang out with your friends and, you know, study with people. So you guys have a great community space in Reed.
Yeah, Reed, very much like Yoakum and Humphreys, are just known for their communities.
Hey, couple questions.
It's a good place to open your door and meet people.
Yes, so this is called the Boy Room. It is a very large study area. It's always has somebody in here studying at night. It's open to you whenever you want to use it. It's open 24 hours. There are separated rooms in case you want something a little more quiet or secluded. I love that it's glass windows because it's really cool. You have a little glass box and you can see what's around you. But this room is really awesome. I use it a lot. People use it for group study sessions, things like that. So if you're roommates in the room and you want to study somewhere more quiet, you can always come down here. There's a lot of spaces for people. This is our recycling station. So we have one of these in every building. We're really big on recycling here. Please do use this instead of just throwing everything away. It's really convenient. It's right when you get off the elevator, so. That's nice. And then we're going to head upstairs. This wall right here, by the way, behind you, our RAs will post information there a lot. So if you ever have any questions, that's a great place to look for events and stuff like that. We're going to go up to the 9th floor because it has the best view.
So you live in Fayetteville. What are the top things for people to know who are not from Fayetteville? To like either check out or go eat at or do.
Dixon Street has great food. Tokyo Sushi is my favorite. It's on Dixon Street. I would definitely recommend going there if you like sushi. I would say the drive-in movie theater is something that's really unique to us. So definitely go check that out.
Hello.
Hello. Room. There's one of these on every floor, located in the same spot on every floor. I personally use this all the time. People would make fun of me because you could always find me in this study room. I lived on the 7th floor, but I definitely took advantage of this because I'm a late night studier. I didn't like walking to the library at night, so this is a great option for that. And I didn't want to bother my roommate, so. And there's a TV in here, which you can use. People also group up and watch stuff in here, like football games, or The Bachelor.
Yeah.
Everybody always watches The Bachelor in here.
Four-level stuff.
Yeah. So, this is nice. And
did you watch The Bachelor this last year?
I'm not a big Bachelor person, but... Oh, here's a water station, by the way. All my friends watch The Bachelor all the time, so I hear about it. We have one of these on every floor as well. This is just a really good way to save plastic. If you bring your own bottle, you can just fill up right here. You don't have to use plastic bottles all the time.
I think we've saved over like 130 tons of plastic in the past 5 years with these water bottle filler stations. So it's a really great tool to use while you're here.
Yes. So this is going to be the bathroom. There's one of these on each side. There's kind of like two wings on every floor. So there's one on each side. This is the side that's going to have stalls, sinks, mirrors if you want to get ready in here. It's always a good option. There's great lighting in here. But yeah, there's a lot of stalls. It's never full. And then here is the other side of the showers. So there's four showers, five actually. This one's bigger. It's like a handicap shower, but you're welcome to use it. If you want to go in there and take a look, I would recommend bringing shower caddies, shower shoes, something easy. There is a nice little changing area on the outside of every shower.
It's a great space. You're never going to run out of hot water, which is great when you live in a building full of girls.
Yes. That is true.
You do come through here twice a day and clean it up.
Let's go back to this way.
So it should always be very clean.
Yes, I clean it twice a day, which is awesome because you don't have to clean your bathroom by yourself.
So treat the rooms nice.
Yes, definitely treat the rooms nice. So we're going to start off in this is a basic room, a normal room in Reed.
So 921, and this is where you're going to live. This is
what the majority of rooms in Reed look like.
Yeah, what rooms are people going to live in, by the way? I'm curious to know. Call out your room.
Yeah. So if you're living in here, you have a great view. I'm going to put this up so you can see how this is. Every room has two beds, two desks, two sets of drawers, two closets, and then the view is my personal favorite part. This is definitely what I'm going to miss the most. You have a great view of the stadium and really all of campus. And you can see Old Main if you look that way. I don't know if you'll be able to get it, but it's really a great view. So while we're in here, let us know if you guys want any measurements. This would be a great time for us to meet in.
Claire is going to be living in 926, so super close.
926.
Everybody on the 9th floor has a great view.
Ninth floor is where it's at. Every building, any building.
Yeah.
Top floor is where you should be.
I lived on the 7th floor, and I have a amazing view, so it's really good.
Yeah. My freshman year, I lived in Hots. I lived on the 9th floor, and that was such an amazing experience.
Yeah. So I'll go ahead and measure this mattress.
Yeah, can I help you out?
Yeah.
Yeah, if you guys have any questions or need us to measure anything, just comment
this
down and we'll do it for you.
80 inches.
Okay.
And 36 across.
Right, it's always 36 across. It's going to be 7 inches deep.
Here is the light, Bailey. It's a. I'll turn it on for you guys. So that's what the light looks like.
Yes.
Lee wants to know what the highest loft of the bed is.
Okay, well, these are brand new bed frames in Reed. I think my freshman year, so this past year was the first year that we had them. They work a little bit differently. So as you can see, if you come over here, there are notches. Here's notches for you to loft the bed. If you want it lofted higher and you request for that, they will actually flip this bed frame over so that these will be higher up for you.
If you go to housing.uark.edu/fixit, you can submit a maintenance request to have the bed lofted for you before you arrive.
Yes.
And Gabby just asked what the measurement from the other side of the bed post, from one side of the bed post to the other is.
Okay. Well, as far as height, this is 60 inches, so she wants this way.
And Claire wants to know what size rug you would recommend.
This is going to be 38 inches across. As far as rugs, I've seen lots of different things. You can always bring a smaller rug to fit in this area. You can always slip it under your bed and put it there if you want. I'll go ahead and measure the length in between the beds in case you want a rug like that.
I'll
hold that in. So it's going to be about 94 inches in between the two beds. So if you do want a carpet that just fits perfectly in between the beds, 94 inches.
Why don't we give them this other dimension as well?
Yes. So look on the edge of the desk.
And all of this furniture is movable so that...
Could you lift it up? Yeah.
Yes. So if you loft your bed, you can always move the desk underneath your bed and have more space in here. It's just up to you guys. Your preference.
Yeah. So that's going to be about 92 inches.
Okay. It says, Olivia wants to know, can you measure the wall on the door side?
Yes. It is going to be, it's upside down, but about 81 inches.
About 81 inches in that
yes.
direction. Lauren's asking if we can go into 912 on our way out. And I think all the rooms are open, so I think we can dip in there for a second.
Yeah.
Leslie asks, will the desk fit under the bed if it is lofted to the highest point?
Yes,
and
if you flip the frame over and get it lofted all the way up, you can slide the desk underneath.
And that top part, is that removable?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
It has to stay in the room,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
but you can move it down.
Okay.
Then if your bed if you want.
And then Juju asks, without flipping the bedpost, how high is the tallest you can make the bed?
I'll go ahead and measure that for you guys. Personally, okay, for this notch, it's going to be about 36 inches.
About 36 inches there.
That is the option that I chose to go with. I did not flip it over, but I did loft it about as high as it would go, and I could fit plastic drawers under there, which I used for more storage. I had a lot of storage space under my bed, actually. And I got, like, a little stool, so you can just climb up on your bed. It's super easy. Me and my roommate both did that, actually, so.
A great idea to, you know, try to accommodate your storage problems. Don't bring all of your clothing at once. Bring a season at a time. So bring your summer/early fall clothing. And then when you go home for fall break or Thanksgiving, switch it out so that you don't have all of your clothes here at one time because you don't need all of them.
Sweaters, yes. Light jackets, yes. Parkas, probably not.
Yeah.
Need that really until right before school ends and then beginning of spring semester. So you should be fine coming back from winter break and bringing that stuff back with you.
Lauren asks, what is the measurement from the top notch to the top of the frame on the bed? And I'm assuming top notch, yeah. So if you were to use it in this current configuration without flipping it.
25 inches.
Okay. Bailey asked him, what increments does the bed go up? Like, how many inches are in between each notch? I think it's probably three inches between each notch.
Because,
yeah.
You know, it's going to be this thick.
Right.
So measure two notches. So,
well, it's six and it's two, but this metal part will sit on the notch. And like we said, housing can do that for you. You can also do it yourself if you bring a rubber mallet. I believe that we loan rubber mallets.
We have some, but moving is such a crazy time that if you're really trying to get it done fast, it's just easier to bring your own.
Mm-hmm.
You'll be thankful for it later that you didn't have to wait in line for a rubber mallet.
Yes.
Yeah, that is definitely one of those items that if you bring yourself, you're going to be happy that you did.
A rubber mallet, a dolly if you want, but yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we'll have another You Are Come Live tour about move-in 2018, so be sure to come back and watch that so you can get all the little move-in tips.
Okay, and Kimberly says, will you go into an end room? Room
yes,
923. And I think that's actually the room we have scheduled to look at.
Yes,
we're going to look at 922 and 923 because one's a corner room and one is an end room, so we're going to look at all of them.
Stacy asks, what is the height of the closet opening from the floor to top shelf and to ceiling?
Well, we have those measurements already, actually, and the height is 96 inches. As far as width, it's 25 inches, and the length is going to be 48 inches.
And I think she's asking about internally inside the closet, the opening from the floor to the top shelf. So right there, the top shelf, yeah.
That's going to be 74 inches.
74, okay. So the whole thing was what, 90-something you mentioned?
Yes, 96.
And then 74 there, okay. Cameron, how long should the curtain in the closet be?
I've also seen two different ways of doing this here. You can do it from where we just measured,
mm-hmm.
which was 74.
Mm-hmm.
And then I did mine from the top. So, because I kept storage units on my top shelf too, which I wanted to cover. So mine was from the top, which was 96 inches.
And our recommendation when it comes to putting a rod up there, which we want you to do, is use a tension rod.
Yes.
That's going to work out well
for you.
That
will be your best bet.
Lee asked, how tall are mattresses? And they are, 7 inches, I think we measured?
Yes, I think so. They're 7 inches.
Mm-hmm. And then Bailey asked, what is the width of the closet where you would hang a rod? And I think we have that.
Yes, we have that measurement, but it's 46 inches.
46 inches, Bailey.
Yes. There's going to be a firm and a soft side to your mattress. And also, you can always bring your own mattress pads and stuff. I know I had one, and it was very helpful.
Laura asks, can you measure the width of the shelf above the vanity? And so the width of the shelf above the vanity, I guess that's the vanity.
Yeah.
This is going to be like 63 inches.
63 inches, okay. Great questions, thank you.
Yeah.
Gabby asks, can you guys go to 909? My room is 209 and there's a ledge that comes out on the ceiling. Does anybody have a piece of paper that could write down, maybe?
I don't have a pen, but 909, which is like 209.
209, and then there was an earlier number that they asked us here. I'll find it. I believe that's right. Let me just verify. 926 was one that was mentioned, and then 912. So if we can remember. I have a terrible head for numbers. That's why
I
ask. Okay, thank you. Gabby, we got you, okay?
909, 926, and 912,
mm-hmm.
and 902.
Did you say there's a ledge in there?
I think she's referring to this ledge, which should be in all the rooms.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
We'll check it out.
I live in 709, so.
Okay. There's an 09 right there.
Yeah.
Bailey, how high do you have to loft the bed to get a 30-inch fridge under the bed? And the notch you'd want to use is what?
I guess just not measured. So
I would go ahead and
one.
Put it on. Well, this is the top, so the second.
Second,
the
top should sort you out there.
Yes.
Okay. Holly, it is very cool. I agree. Bailey asked, how dark does the room get with the blinds down?
I think it's pretty dark. People bring curtains. I did not bring curtains. I didn't think that they are necessary, and my bed was on the window side. So
yeah, I never had a curtain.
Yeah, you're good without it. It does get pretty dark. I know that me and my roommate
this is a good example of how dark it gets. We would never use the top light. We always, when we like wanted to nap during the day, which we did a lot after class, we would turn off all the lights and close the blinds, and I mean, I would sleep for hours. it gets pretty dark in there, so.
Laura asks, is there a drawer that has a lock on it in here?
There's not. Mm-hmm. You can rent safes mm-hmm. from the university.
Collegiate Concepts is our vending partner yeah. with that.
Yes, but there is not a drawer in here that locks.
A great thing for these rooms is the university has cable, which they provide for you. So if you bring a TV, you have cable, HBO, a whole bunch of channels. So that's a nice little gift or amenity for this
mm-hmm.
place.
Mm-hmm. Game of Thrones is coming back?
2019.
Okay. Kimberly asks, what is the height of the mid-shelf in the closet? So if we can just give that little measurement there.
9 inches.
9 inches. Claire asks, what's the height of the shelf above the mirror? And have we gotten one?
I think she's asking about this. About
16
inches.
16 inches. And there's a little lip there, too.
Yes.
That
yes.
goes over. So let's see. And we're caught up with questions.
Awesome.
Right on. Keep sending them in. We're interested to answer them. Let's go ahead and start taking a look at some of these other rooms. So this is sort of the standard room, and now we're going to go look at what, a corner?
Corner. Mm-hmm. Now
I'm going to pass this back to you.
Yes.
I lived in a corner room, and it is very similar to all the other rooms. There is such a minor difference. One of those being that both of these beds are actually going to be 80 inches long, because this wall is just a tiny bit longer at 80 inches, as you can see. So it allows the bed to be longer without the door hitting it when it closes. So yeah, this is a corner room. Feel free to ask us to take any measurements while we're in here.
Great view of campus.
One question we get a lot is about the cork boards. And yes. So just know that they do have to remain in place.
Yes.
But you are welcome to cover them over or do any decorative stuff you want to.
Yes, I brought a headboard that just slipped right over this and covered that. Really easy way to do it.
Yeah. Any outlets. Questions, guys? Be sure to let us know.
I want to point out where the outlets are because I know that we definitely use them a lot. So each desk has one right above the desk. Now, this furniture is movable, so you don't have to leave your room set up like this. I didn't. We kind of moved the stuff around a little bit, just whatever you prefer.
Lee is asking how many outlets are in each room.
So there's going to be two above these desks, so 1, 2, 3, and then there should be one in that corner. Right there.
Thank you.
4.
1, right.
So 4 times 2? 8?
Yes, so 8 total, and we do allow you to bring
surge protectors, you know, extension cords, things like that.
Yes. The closet measurements are going to be the same. Really the only main difference is this wall has a little bit more length, so the bed is a little bit longer. I know a lot of people use these walls to decorate. We don't let you like penetrate the walls in any way, but you can bring command strips. They work awesome if you use them correctly.
Just be sure to be very careful when you take them off, because if you strip paint off the walls, there is a damage, and
yes.
you will be charged for it. But
yes.
if you take them off carefully, it should be A-okay. I know I use command strips, and I never got charged because you just take them off. Lee's asking what the depth of the window ledge is.
Okay. It is going to be about 14 inches. 14 inches deep. That's a good place to put decorations and stuff as well. I had a little cactus that sat on my ledge all year. We also chose to sit our microwave here because of this outlet in the corner. So, and you can bring your microwave, you can bring one from us, you can bring coffee machines, a Keurig.
Laura asked about the bulletin boards and then removing them and putting them back up. Officially, housing says don't do that.
That's our official position on that, but
yeah. Any other questions
about the corner rooms? We can do some more measurements if you guys would like.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we'll go and do the in room. We can come back.
I do want to point out that they just installed these. These are brand new, and you can control the temperature within your room. But the building is set on either heat or air. You can't switch that. It's the building as a whole, but you can control it within that range in your room.
So what that oftentimes means is that on a warm November day, or a very cold May day or April day, that you might be somewhat uncomfortable. So be sure you have a fan during that time or a blanket to use.
Yeah.
But you can also control, you can make some adjustments there with that.
It's not always open your window. I did that a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Lindsay wants to know if an 8x10 rug will fit under the bed. And I think, yes, it will. I had one in my room, and it fit pretty good.
Yeah. You can always, if it's longer than the length in between the bed, just lift up the bed and slip it under. I think mine did that.
Or will it get caught under the desk chair? It probably would.
Mm-hmm.
It should roll fine on top of carpet. It wouldn't hinder the chair. But yes.
So we want to check out a end room?
Yes.
I think 923 was a room that someone wanted to see.
Yes, it was.
So the end rooms are going to be a little bit different. There's two on each floor. We're going to head in here.
When you send, Olivia asks if we send their maintenance request to loft the bed, how high will they loft the bed? And if you send it to have it lofted, they're going to loft it to the highest point, which means that they will flip this bar over and turn it around and loft it all the way up. You can also loft it up. You can move it to whatever height that you would like with a rubber mallet, or leave specific instructions in the maintenance request and see if that can help you.
Yes, you can definitely do that. So you're going to have the same bed, same desk, same furniture. You just have two separate drawer areas, mirrors. You actually have these nice cabinets above here.
Ashley asked, did we use chairs for the vanity? I didn't. You lived here. Did you have a chair for your vanity?
I did not. But there's great lighting.
Yes.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Turn on the lights. Kimberly
asked if we can pull the blinds in this room.
Sure.
Yes. So that is one thing about the in rooms. We do have.
That's the
trade
off.
Here right now,
that's
but
the trade-off.
This is the trade off. There is some break out there, so your view is not as great, but it is a larger room.
Kimberly asked what the measurements between the beds in this room are.
In this room. Would you mind doing that for me?
Yeah. We'll do the frame, because that'll effectively be where you'll be limited.
That's
100. Are you on the mattress or the frame?
I'm going to the frame.
Okay.
And it's 134 inches. So.
Kimberly also asks if the ledge is the same in this room as the others.
It's going to be about 14 inches deep, which I think is what we said on the other one as well.
Mm-hmm. I think they're all pretty consistent on that lift.
It probably will be longer though, so.
Yeah. Okay.
133 inches.
Okay. You're up in there, thank you.
Yes.
133 inches.
Woo! You got it.
All right. And Kimberly, so what is the distance between the desks?
So push to
their
furthest points, it's probably going to be about 46 inches. Right?
About 46 inches?
And these are movable.
Yes. So if you lock your bed, you can put it underneath. You can probably have space for like a couch or something in here.
Yeah.
Up to you.
Yeah.
You could always move the bed this way, desk over there. I know it fits. I had a friend do that last year. So there's a lot of options as far as moving furniture.
Yes, there is.
Lee asked, do all rooms have desk chairs?
Yes.
They all do. You want to show the desk chair trick real quick?
Yes. So we have special chairs. There is a little hook which just attaches this into a little rocking chair.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a little gaming chair. And
so
you can use this as a store.
If you have lots of friends over, you need more seating, you can always pull apart your chairs and have some more space for people to sit down.
And Kimberly wants to know how many outlets are in this room. There were eight in the other
one.
Both
mirrors, so one, two, Yes, there's one right here, so 3, 4.
There's one on this side.
Yes. So 8 as well. Yes. 8. Awesome.
Okay, 8 is what we're coming up with. Bailey asks, do the rooms come with a trash can? And would you recommend getting a recycle bin for the room?
The rooms, these are new trash cans. So they didn't have these last year, but they are coming with these trash cans this year. I would recommend, you could bring a recycling bin. I know that I just kind of kept mine in a separate sack and would carry that down that way. Whatever works best for you. You can always bring a bigger trash can as well, or you can each have your own trash can, so whatever works for you guys.
In my office now, in my desk, I have a little recycling trash can, and it's kind of cute.
Yeah.
And so it's always nice to have one of those little ones.
Yeah, you can always use this little one right here that's going to be coming with your room as a recycling trash can or recycling bin, and then bring your own trash cans in.
Yes.
You.
Candace asks if you send in a request to off the bed, it'll automatically be flipped over. I believe so. You could also leave in specific instructions if you don't want it lofted all the way up, just to the midpoint, I would say. But it's also very easy to do yourself.
Yeah.
Right. So if you get here and it's lofted in a position that you're not totally comfortable with, then just cloth rubber mallet, or even I think you can just kind of use your hands.
Yes, it's really
not difficult to do yourself. I did it myself, lofting at the beginning of the year and bringing it back down at the end of the year.
Kimberly asked what the dimensions of the vanity are in this room.
Okay, so it's going to be about 32 inches wide and about 34 and a half.
How deep?
23 inches, exactly.
Dottie asks if one or two refrigerators are allowed. You can have as many refrigerators as you want in the room. You don't have to bring a refrigerator because you do have one downstairs in the kitchen. So it's not necessary, like, you don't really need it. But you can have one, you can have two for the different roommates.
Me and my roommate had one, and we just shared it. And it was plenty of space for the both of us, so.
We do have rental refrigerators that you can use as well. And the nice thing about that is they deliver it. It shows up when you're here, or it's here before you're here, and then it leaves on its own. You don't have to worry about taking it. When it comes to the refrigerators that you may buy, the mini fridges, we do have some sort of power restrictions we ask that you follow, just because we don't want to pull so much energy that breakers get switched or get flipped or anything like that.
Kimberly asks what the distance between the end of the bed and the closet is.
Okay. I'm going to go ahead and say about 24. Let me go to the bottom to make sure. Yeah, it's
going
to be about 21 inches.
21 inches, Kimberly. These are great questions, guys.
Yeah, that's good. The closet should be about the same. I'll go ahead and check. Yes, 46 and a half.
Yeah.
So one more.
What is the size of the shelf above the vanity?
So this is a nice little cabinet which you can use. It is about 16 inches tall.
And Andrea asked what the measurements of the desk are.
Going to be 42 inches. And then, so I'm going to go around this. 22 inches deep.
And that little bookshelf on top is removable.
Yes.
So it doesn't have to stay there.
And this is really convenient. You can decorate it, you can put books on it.
Nicole asks if the end room is the same size of the end rooms in Pomfret B.
I'm not sure about that. I know that we've put a lot of those measurements of mattresses on movein.york.edu, and of the halls themselves, like inside, you want to go to housing.york.edu, and then campus communities, and then HOTS honors hall, and that would be, we'll tell you that. We are going to be touring HOTS next week, so hopefully you can join us for that.
Yeah.
Yes. Lauren asked what the measurement from the desk to the underside of the hutch, the bookshelf, is. So from the bottom of the bookshelf
to the desk. Oh.
Yes.
19 inches.
Kathleen asked how many inches is it if you loft the bed on the next to top notch to the floor?
Next to top notch is going to be 32
inches, because for a bed skirt, so yeah, that will be that.
Yeah.
Well, there were some requests to see some other rooms too.
Yes.
We've looked at the main room, we've looked at the corner room. Did you go to the corner room? Yes.
Yes.
And
so
then,
I think someone wants to see 926, so we'll pop in there. Oh, this way. So this is going to be 926, and this is what the bed looks like when it's lofted all the way up.
Someone turned in a lofting request.
Yes.
Yeah.
So this is
how high the desk will be, how high the bed will be when you loft it all the way to the top rung. So yeah, someone created this is what...
Don't show
them. Yeah, no. This is what this is going to be.
Cool.
And I think you can even go higher if necessary.
Awesome. So you can see, it gives you a lot more space for storage.
Mindy asked
necessary.
If we can measure this.
Yeah, just like the height.
Yes.
So I'm going to go ahead and do from underneath this to the floor.
Do you need help or you got it?
I think I got it. Yes, 51 inches.
Yeah. 51 inches.
Okay.
Great.
So I believe you can even go up like one or two notches above this and make it even higher.
Yes.
So.
This is, so flipped over just so you guys know, this one is lofted two down from the top. Two notches from the top notch.
Yeah, so.
Were there some other rooms that people want to see? I think
912.
Okay.
909, 92.
We're all
gotcha.
Over the ninth floor.
Yes.
The penthouse.
Yeah. Keep
so
your questions coming, guys. These are great questions.
Trashu, do we want a trashu?
So you will take your trash down to the first floor trash room that we showed you guys earlier. Like we said, the bathroom's in the same spot, just on both sides, both wings.
Yes, this is another bathroom right here. 912, someone wanted to see.
Oh.
So,
yeah.
Ashley asked if she can bring a wireless printer. And no, I believe you can't because it messes with the Wi-Fi, but restrictions for that are going to be on housing.uark.edu under our ResNet.
And honestly, that question, the answer has changed a little bit in the last year or two,
yeah.
So we'll make sure that we try to answer that here in the thread.
Yes.
To give you the proper answer, because I don't want to not answer correctly for you on that.
Kimberly asked, what is the height of the metal frame from the mattress? Is it? That the mattress sits on.
The
so,
height?
Yes, yeah, so like. I think she's asking for how tall this is.
Just the metal part?
Is it how, yes, how tall the frame was.
It's just 2 inches.
Okay. 2 inches.
2 inches, okay. Thanks, Gabby. Let's.
We'll show you guys where the stairs are when we come around this corner. I know someone asked about that. So yeah, you can take the stairs. A little walk from the ninth floor, but it'll be good.
903 was a request as well.
Yes, okay. So 909,
902,
903.
They all look very similar.
They do.
You know, great views on this side of the hall.
Yes. So I was in this exact room, but 2 floors down.
Oh,
great.
So you were on the, not the corner. Yeah, this is a corner
room.
Yes,
the corner, 709.
Okay.
Sorry.
Yeah, can't wait for the stadium to be done.
And you can
see
hear the games,
right,
which is really fun. If you like left the game early, which I did a lot because I just get tired of walking.
You
can see
the screen.
When they score, you know when they score because you can hear it, which is awesome.
You really can. I mean, I live a couple miles away, and I can still hear the stadium erupt.
Yeah, we get real into it. So, you know, this football season, we're coming hard. You know, we're gonna, it's a new leaf.
New coach, right?
New coach, new stadium.
All right.
New attitude.
Yep.
So let's check out these other rooms. Got a 903 and a 905.
And a 902. So around this corner is going to be the stairs. So there's stairs on either side of the building, but this is where the stairwell is.
We do have an elevator, of course. You don't have to go up 9 flights of stairs.
Of course.
There's the elevator. 905.
Okay.
Your view is
there's 905 for Lauren. Lauren asked about 905 just now.
You're going to be able to see the parking lot from here. Some great trees, like some more Fayetteville and Springdale area.
You can see the hills, which is pretty.
Yes.
Yeah. Very much so.
Yeah. I don't know if we pointed these out earlier, but there are two racks for you to hang your towels after you shower. Which are convenient.
Okay, 903 was one.
Here is 903. Beautiful.
Here we are. For you, Holly. Here you are.
Welcome to your crib.
Okay, were there any numbers that we didn't get a chance to
902.
902.
Ooh, right next to
Taya's got you for 902. Okay.
I remember.
Neighbors.
Here we are. 902.
It's a great idea those first couple days you guys are here. Keep your doors open, meet new people. It's a great way to make new friends and
absolutely
just experience more. So, highly recommend that.
My next door neighbors are now my best friends.
Yes.
And my roommate was amazing. Hope you all get as lucky as I did because it was great.
And you're living, are you living with some of the people you met here?
I am. I'm living with not the people that are my neighbors or my roommate, but I am living with people who all three of them I was not friends with before college. So I met them all freshman year. They're all some of my best friends now.
Yeah.
It's really crazy how fast you become close with people in college. It's kind of amazing.
You bond real tight.
Yes. You make friends in the bathroom when you're brushing your teeth together.
Yes.
You make friends everywhere. So definitely get to know as many people as you can because it makes the experience very fun.
Yes. You have to make the experience worth it. So put some effort in and you'll get great things back. So get out of your room, get out of the dorm, you know, experience things on campus, meet new people. Learn new things. It'll be great.
I miss freshman year already.
Oh, I know, right? I don't even want to think about it.
We had a couple of other questions come in, but we're starting to wrap up too. But Mary asked about what are the corner, are the corner was bigger in Pomfret Hall. We are not touring Pomfret Hall this year, but we have the last 2 years. We're not touring because of renovation that's occurring there. There is a thread though on Facebook that we'll link you to, and we'll get that answer for you, either in this thread or in the Pomfret thread. Kimberly asked, do we need to bring a doorstop or will the door stay open by itself?
The doors will stay open by themselves.
It'll stay open by itself, but warning, if your window is open and your door is open,
it will close the door.
Sometimes they tend to slam shut and it scares everyone, so beware.
Ghosts in the halls, okay. Yes. Well, you both offered quite a bit of advice for our incoming students. Let's go ahead and sign off. And
yeah. Can't wait to see you guys in the fall. Welcome to the university. You guys are going to have a great time here.
Yes, I'm jealous of all of you that get to experience Reed for the first time. If I could go back in time and do it all over again, I definitely would. So have fun and be sure to ask us any more questions that you come up with. I will go through and answer those for you guys. But thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you'll have a great year.
We'll pick Suey.
We'll pick Suey.